Let us look at the case where N and M, I am considering two nodes for both W and Psi. So in this particular case, both Psi 1 and Psi 2 will be equal to, the interpolation functions for both of them will be equal to X bar 1 minus X bar. Okay. Now, fine. So first, in order to derive these block matrices, I first initialize them, okay, to be zero matrices of size K11 is of size M cross M, K12 M cross N, K21 is transpose of K12, K22 is of size N cross N. So I initialize them, I also initialize the F vectors. Then what is it? So for I going from 1 to M, J going from 1 to N, 1 to M again, K11, IJ. So we have the expressions for block matrices, K11, 12, 22 and F1. So whatever are the expressions, I just evaluate them, okay, and I get my block matrices. Now, and this particular code is generic. I could evaluate it for m equals to 2, n equals to 2, or I could evaluate it for m equals to 3, n equals to 2. So first let me evaluate it for m equals to 2, n equals to 2. So when I do this, okay, when I do this, so I get my matrices, okay. So if I say, let's say matrix form of K11, okay, I get my matrices, all right. Now, so when N and M are both equals to 2, okay, I do not have any internal nodes, right? And so for this case, there is no elimination of anything, okay, but still there is this question of rearranging the equations. So in order to rearrange, what I am doing is, so first I am going to initialize my element K matrix and F vector of size 4 cross 4 and 4 cross 1. So WV, Psi V, in this case W vector will be W1, W2, Psi vector will be Psi 1, Psi 2, Q vector will be, so remember capital Q is the boundary forces in this case, so it is QE1, QE3 and Q2 will be QE2, QE4. Now, what is the element matrix equation coming from force balance? If you remember, it is K times K11 times W vector plus K12 times Psi vector minus F1. Equation is actually equals to F1 plus Q1, but what I am doing is I am bringing all terms to one side and I am calling it as equation 1. So force balance equation, so what is happening? So what is the force balance equation? There is some problem. What is the force balance equation? This sometimes tends to happen. Let me do one thing, okay? I will just open a new notebook. I don't know why this happens, but it happens sometimes in this cloud that whatever I am typing, it goes to the last line. Okay, so I just copied the whole code.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah,
it's because your block is too lengthy.
Oh, but you see, if I copy it and run this again, it again runs fine. Okay. Why is this weird? Okay, something is not right. Let me leave this. Let me go back to mine. So, okay, let me follow your advice. Let me try to make this smaller. Okay, so see, even now it's happening. I don't know, there is some strange thing going on. Okay, no, it's fine. All right, so what exactly is my force balance statement for the element domain? It is actually equation 1 is equal to 0. That's my force balance statement. Okay, and similarly, this equation 2 equals to 0 is my moment balance statement. Okay, everybody clear until here? Until here, is this point clear to everyone? Is there anyone who has doubt here? No, right? So we derived the weak form statement, we imposed the functions, we imposed the expressions for W and psi in terms of W at the nodes and interpolation functions for W, and for psi we wrote it as psi at the nodes multiplied by interpolation functions for psi. So, from there we got this matrix equations. Now, what we are going to do is, what is happening? Just one second. Oh, I was at the wrong location. Okay, so I derived my element matrices and here. Yeah, so now, okay, so in the element matrix equation that I am finally going to have, okay, my the force balance equations will be which all rows in the final element matrix equation that I am deriving? What are all the rows where force balance will be imposed?
One and three.
Very good. So force balance equation, first force balance equation will go to row number 1 and second force balance equation will go to row number 3. So, and the first column in the element matrix will multiply W1, second column will multiply Psi1, third column will multiply W2, fourth column will multiply Psi2. So, for this reason, I use, sorry, it's getting messed up. So, for this reason, I use this code in order to I use this code in order to get the entries for row number 1 and 3. And then which all rows I am implementing moment balance in my final, in my element matrix. I am implementing it in row number 2 and row number 4. So row number 2 would correspond to the first row for equation 2. Row number 4 will correspond to the row number 2 in equation 2. And once again, column 1 multiplies W1, column 2 psi 1, column 3 W2, column 4 psi 2. So I use this set of code in order to get my entries for KE. Okay, and now when we come to F vector, so this is the this is irritating me today. One second. When I come to the F vector, okay, so this is the mapping. So based on all of this, I finally get my KE and FE, and I can go ahead and get the C form of KE FE and assign it. Okay, this is for n equals to m equals to 2. Now if I take m as 3 and determine my matrices. Okay, the first point I want to raise is maybe one of you can tell me. So my K12 is coming like this. Actually, if I compare it with the book I have, the columns are interchanged. Means whatever I am getting in column 1, the book shows this in column 2, and whatever I am getting in column 2, the book shows it in column 1. Can anybody confirm as to the K12 for m equals to 3 and n equals to 2, whether they are getting the same thing or different? So did you get K12 like minus 5, minus 1? You got that? Sure. I don't know why I am getting this. So K12 is this, right? Check whether.
Sir.
Huh?
I also got in the similar way in the book.
Okay, just check the expression, this expression, whatever I have highlighted for K12.
Sir, I think first you place n and r, I mean I less than or equals to n, j less than or equals to m.
Why, Baba? For K12, I ranges from 1 to m. That is correct. Rows has to be 3.
Sir, can you show K12 matrix again? I think I also got same like
K12. This is what I am getting. So all of you are getting the second. Huh?
So in the K12 matrix, when you defined the psi 1, there you in bracket you return that I comma 1. If we do not write that I comma 1, simply we write I there.
No. The way I am doing it, no. I have to do it as I comma 1 only. This constant array thing, I have to do I comma 1, otherwise I'm getting some problem. That is not an issue. I or I comma 1, depending on how you have written things, it should be fine. But expression is this only, right? You have used the same expression or you have changed the expression? What?
Sir, can you show the interpolation function, sir?
Interpolation functions will be the same, no? So, psi 1 for m equals to 3 will be these three interpolation functions.
Actually, in book, they have taken the minus into there and they have written is half minus x bar and 1 minus x bar.
That doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. It will be the same. You can multiply both terms by minus 1. It won't change anything. No, the other matrices are all coming fine. I don't know, there is this strange thing going on as to why I am getting it, this thing. The only logic I have is, so for psi, it is x bar and psi 2, you have chosen it as x bar and 1 minus x bar only, right? Oh, I have reversed it. Okay. So this was supposed to be 1 minus x bar and x bar, right? That's why I think I got it exact opposite. So now I think I should be fine. The other ones were fine. Somehow here I messed it up. So K12, yeah, so now it matches, it's fine. K11 and other things, somehow it didn't matter really. It won't matter anyhow. K22, fine. This is all fine now. Okay, so now once I get these matrices, now let me show you what I do for the other case. So this is the code for m equals to 3 and n equals to 2, m equals to 3 and n equals to 2. And in this particular case, now what I will have is I have a internal node, which I will have to eliminate. So the way I am eliminating this is I again define the matrix equation for force balance, matrix equation for the moment balance, and then what I do is I take the equation for the internal node and I solve for the internal node in terms of the other primary variables, that I am denoting it with WCS. And then what I do is, what is happening? Oh, I think I have. After that, what I do is I simplify my equation 1 by substituting whatever I have solved for WC. I do the same thing for equation 2. And then again, I do the mapping. So now again, first row is force balance equation 1. Third row is force balance for the last node. So based on that, I go to the corresponding row in equation 1 and first column will be the coefficient for W1, second column will be coefficient for psi 1, third column will be coefficient for W2, fourth column will be coefficient for psi 2. And once I get the once I get the row 1 and 3, then I can get row 2 and 4 by by looking at moment balance for the first node and the last node. And so from equation 2, I get rows number 2 and 4. And for F, what I do is I know that F means equation 1 is K correspond K times W minus F minus Q. So from there I get my F vector, and after that I simplify things, okay, so and get my final KE and FE, okay. So I get my final KE and FE. Any doubts or questions? Any doubts? No? Okay. So once you get this KE and FE, you can go ahead and write your MATLAB functions.